Hi guys, welcome back to Simply Created. If you're new to my channel, don't forget to share, like, and hit that notification bell so you are notified whenever I upload. Today, we're going to be doing two of my favorite DIY projects using Dollar Tree products. Some of the items I did get on Amazon, which I will go ahead and link in the description box below for you to check them out as well. So let's jump right in. So what I have here is one of the tall vases from Dollar Store, and I also found this thicker jute rope that I'm going to go ahead and wrap on the bottom half of the vase. First, I'm going to take my painter's tape because I want some dimension from the top and the bottom, and I want this to really look farmhouse. That's what I have my living room and my dining room currently, and I want to go ahead and put this in my entryway table. So I'm taking some painter's tape, and this does not have to be perfect, guys. You know, that's the whole point about being artistic, is just following what you're feeling and having fun with it. So I first taped that around the top part of the vase, about an inch and a half or two, and now I'm just taking my jute rope and hot glue gunning it to the bottom of the vase, and I'm just going to wrap that around the vase until I'm happy with where it stops. I think for this I ended up using one entire bunch of the jute rope, and as I got midway through, I noticed that it was starting to lift a little bit because I was only putting glue right there as opposed to all the way around as I was wrapping. But thankfully I caught it early enough where I was able to push that down right there and then glue it. So I'm gonna go ahead and continue wrapping here, and we're gonna speed this up. Alright, now that the vase is all in my jute rope, I've decided to take some white paint to give it more of a farmhouse look and lightly brush that on the jute rope. Now, my initial idea was to use a lighter to go ahead and burn some of those, you know, spiky hairs that are out of the jute rope and leave it as is, but I really, really like how it came out painting the bottom part white. Now I'm taking off the painter's tape because I did go ahead and paint the top of the vase as well. And I mean, it came out absolutely gorgeous. I love how this turned out. I know that the edges weren't straight across, but that's what makes this piece unique. And then I went ahead and I purchased some full plants off of Amazon that I just placed in here and went ahead and displayed it in two different places just to see which one I preferred. And I ended up putting it on my entryway table. So here are two different looks for you guys. The next DIY project that we're going to get into is a table piece center for my dining room table. Again, this one is also going to be farmhouse and was really, really fun to make. It did take me about a week because I have been back to work, but a huge stress reliever. So I'm really excited to share this one with you guys. Let's get straight to it. So I am starting off with Waverly chalk paint and crystal. I have one large charger here from the dollar store. a medium plate, and then a salad plate as well. I'm gonna go ahead and paint all three of these plates front and back because I do want a seamless look and I don't want any silver or red from my other plate to be poking out. I went ahead and I did about three coats on these so I get a really nice matted finish on the plates. So I'm gonna go ahead and finish painting these up and then we'll go on to the next step. Now that the plates are painted, we'll put them off to the side to dry. I'm going to go ahead and start wrapping my three candle holders. I have a small, medium, and large from Dollar Tree. I'm going to go ahead and hot glue this from the base and twirling it all the way up until I get to the top. I decided to use a jute rope because I wanted some contrast and dimension between my pillars to hold up my three-tiered tray and the matte finish on the paint for my plates. So I'm going to go ahead and wrap these three up and then we'll go on to the next step. Alright, so now that they are all done, I went ahead and took a lighter so I can give it a little bit more of a rustic look, and I burned off the little hairs that come off of the jute twine with a lighter. Now you can do this as many times as you like. Try not to do it too much because you don't want it to go on fire. But yeah, that really gives it a nice clean look. So now that that's done, we're gonna go ahead and put some bottoms down at the bottom of the plates so my table doesn't get scratched. I got these beads off of Amazon and I'm just placing them where I want them to be. I ended up using six of these, two on the rounded part on each side as well as the reverse side, if that makes sense. And I decided to go ahead and paint these black. I didn't want you to see the lighter neutral tone of the wood on these. And then I filled the little holes that come with these beads with some hot glue gun so again I don't scratch my dining room table. And that's what you're seeing me do here. I'm reinforcing it with E6000 because I do want this to be stable and last me a long time and not fall apart. I find it easier to use the smaller bottles of the E6000. I usually finish them during one DIY project, so it's easier for me to just throw it in the trash. I don't know, what do you guys think? Go ahead and leave comments below. I'm gonna go ahead and continue painting here and then we'll go on to the next step. Now that that's nice and dry and stable, we're going to go ahead and start putting our trays down. I'm starting with the largest candlestick first, putting some E6000 and some hot glue gun, again to reinforce this because I want this to be stable. And I'm just going to go ahead and stack up my plates, going from large candle hold stick to medium to then small. Now that my tray is all dry, I wanted this to pop a little bit more, so these plates came with their own little grooves in them all the way around. I decided to take a really thin paintbrush, dip it in some white paint, and create those dots right over. Came out super, super cute, and this is what it looks like. Alright guys, that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed our two DIY projects. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you are notified whenever I upload. Until the next time, lovelies, stay safe and stay healthy.